These three are older infrared TV remotes. These older ones don't make EMF in standby. These three only make EMF when buttons are pushed. So there are differences between old and new infrared TV remotes, and this EMF meter confirms this. All the newer infrared remotes I tested make EMF all the time in standby. There are no remotes in this video that emit something like Wi-Fi or Bluetooth. This older remote does not emit the same EMF like the new remotes do. When buttons are pressed, this EMF meter doesn't measure anything in this mode. If EMF sensitivity would be a nocebo effect, as some claim, you would expect that I would feel pain from holding all these remotes, or it would be random. But this is not the case. There is a pattern. I only feel pain from the modern remotes that were seen on the left. The older remotes on the right side do not trigger pain for me. Coincidentally, this matched with what the Esmog Spion detected on the remotes in standby. But there is more to it than that, because all remotes make EMF when buttons are pressed. All the remotes that I have emit a magnetic field. Meanwhile, this is also again a good example of the differences between EMF meters. That 4 nanotesla on the white device is not coming from the remote. It's from this house or from the cables in the street. So, because all remotes emit some kind of EMF, I suspect that the painful remotes use different modulations or they emit different dirty fields. When you have a person with an allergy for peanuts, did you know that the same person can be fine with other nuts? Would it make sense to say to that person, "Hey, you can't be allergic to nuts because you aren't allergic to all nuts. You are crazy." For EMF sensitive people, this is comparable. One source isn't necessarily the same as another. But there can be different effects. Instead of pain, it can be more vague, like fatigue and brain fog, for example. EMF effects are often sneaky. Even though it's not always simply about the strength of the EMF, stronger fields obviously can have worse effects. And the newer remotes I tested did often have stronger EMF output as well. Doing a continuous push probably reveals the full strength better, because values on devices often react slowly. I had to make this for my TV remote, so I can use it without pain. It's annoying having to do this. It's slow. In contrast, the remote of my Yamaha receiver I can use in my hand just fine. It would be better if they would make the remotes like they used to be.